What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another installment of Chronicles of Teddy, Finding Teddy 2, whatever the hell we're going to call this by the time this video series is finished. Back in the Dark Palace, having a lot of fun. My mood's pretty high. Now we got to go look for the musical notes to open the square X. So like I said, I hypothesize this converging path in this room right here. This one up here is going to leave us to the musical notes for one side of the thing, and then... Well, at least they're not bum rushing me. You idiot. You moron. Now I need a key. Damn it! Ah! Oh, shit. Come on. There we go. That's not fair! It pushed me back! See, and I can't jump into the next zone. That's messed up. And I was just about to pay this game a compliment saying, the combat is so satisfying once you figure it out. In other words, not playing it the way probably not the way the developers intended you to play, but like I said in the previous episode, you have to work with what is given to you. Focus on what you can do, not what you can't do. Because if you do, you'll grow endlessly frustrated and then throw your controller at the TV. And then have to buy a new TV. God fucking damn it, I still can't believe I did that. Shit! You know, that's another thing I just realized. I really should be awarding you health based on whether you're doing a stylish kill or not. Kind of like Devil May Cry. Oh, sweet. Tafa, baby. Nice! Alright, we got a key. Now we can double back to the other end of the hallway. There's so many layers, background layers going on in here. This is a really, like, the aesthetics of this, this whole dungeon is just fantastic. The mood is conveyed by the music, suitably heavy, but moving quick enough to keep you motivated, saying, like, you're close to the end of your journey, you just got one, well, if you're not being a completionist, this is it. Oh, hey! Ran. I understand. I hope you're not trapped in here, buddy, but now you're free. Okay, square is ran. Yeah, okay. Alright, well, that's cool. Hey, thank you for sharing. And this, dungeon is, linear, because it isn't, it's definitely branching, but it's definitely, more straightforward than the, ice dungeon. Ice palace, rather. Because when I think dungeons, I usually think they're underground. Doing the duck walk and stabbing dudes. Interesting. Oh. Oh, that's definitely more straightforward. Thank goodness they don't shoot in a straight line. It's arcing over, so that way you can actually have a chance to avoid it. Maybe if they had it so that they actually shot in different directions, you know? Maybe it did that. Maybe that would... Ooh. Nope. I got an idea. Back it up a little bit. Get a running start. I need to push... I need to... I need a... Goodness gracious, she can cover a lot of distance. There we go. She's been eating her Wheaties, my goodness. Oh, hey, what's up? Tao. Ran Tao? Is that the boss's name? Definitely want to play this with pen and paper. Or have your cell phone handy to take pictures. Because if you don't have a COCOM like Shelby, they can give you assistance at the drop of a hat. You're really on your own. I love that. Hopefully this will lead to the master scroll. Okay. So it's Ran Tao. Okay. So it's presumably square is first because it's on top. Okay. Ran Tao. Yeah, no, that's... Where's the end, though? Oh, it's the last music comp piece. Ran Tao. There we go. Those guys. Explode! Magic. Yeah, we're probably gonna get the Master Scroll here real soon. So those blue guys don't seem to be any functionally different from the red guys. Other than being a different color. They don't have any... Maybe they do more damage. Because they don't take they seem to be taking the same amount of damage. Oh, speak of the devil. Still enough ceiling, I can still do it. Ooh. Very, very, very close. Still can do it, though. What's up, buddy? You idiot! You moron! Okay. Yeah, if you don't want to turn around, that's fine by me. Oh. Okay, so we got double diamond. So now we need to know, we need to look for double diamond. Ooh, that was bad. Freaking bat. Feel like I need to go up and push something down first. Let us go back and explore the other routes. Because it feels like that's supposed to be the exit. Well, I don't know if this it's the game with random number generation or something, but like I'm getting a lot more health on random drops than I ever had previously. Which is fine. just wondering where was all that earlier. Shit! Splitting paths, huh? Oh. Oh. Diamond. Okay. So it seems to be doing the door thing from the Ice Palace, but definitely in a less brutal fashion. And certainly not throwing enemies at you at places where you've got so little ability to move. I think that's what really made the Ice Palace as hard as it was. Also, the whole thing was just hard. Do I have a key? No, I don't. Jesus. Okay. Well, dead end for now. We climb. But first we wait. Oh, or not. That's cool. Ooh. Shit. I hate these guys. About to break 6,000. Which would be good. Fuck me. There we go. Oh, hello. False ceiling. All right, that works. Nice. Fall damage and platforming is bullshit. God, imagine how much harder Metroid Prime would have been if Samus took fall damage. Because there are some dizzying heights you fall from in that game. Oops, it's the lower one that has the key. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, 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 boom. Bum 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 bum. There we go. Hey, now we got a lead. Hazane. Okay, I'm not quite following the pattern here of what you're trying to, Hazane. Haza Sisi. Oh, that's supposed to be an E. Oh man, I've been calling it CC this entire time. Haza CC. Haza E. Dang. It's like... So, my mother is a French teacher, right? But she, in her early teaching years, when she was teaching at this place called Notre Dame Academy, which was a all-girl Catholic school, yeah, in Middleburg, Virginia, and it was famous for having a 100% success graduation rate, because if they thought any inkling that you were going to fail, they would kick you out. Like, that's it, you're gone. So, I think it's maybe the room above. So, in order to fulfill the requirement for the job, she had to teach English because they didn't need just a French teacher. Yet. So she taught French and English. But here's the thing. She went her entire teaching career calling cacophony. If you look it up in the dictionary, it's certainly not pronounced that way. So yeah, that's what I feel like I've heard. Just like, Mom, it's not cacophony, it's cacophony. So it's like I've gone this entire game calling this note CC. It's an E. Huzzah, E. Dang. Don't I feel like a dumbass? The next contestant is Dumbass. Your question is, save the game. The answer is very yes. Oh my god. Well, now we gotta wait. We got a fish fry. Get some health back. Oh my god, you can drop down underneath that? I don't know why you would want to, but you can. Alright. Boom, boom, boom. Pardon my bad whistling. I'll just keep with humming. Props to the developer for having stabs in addition to big, wide swings. And a downward stab at the end as a finisher. Jesus. Fuck. Those guys. Come on. Oh, look at that. Something to push down. Guess who wasn't wrong? Come on. Gamma! And that's probably good right there. Perfect. Hey, what's up, buddy? Kaura? What? Ka-ra-oo-ra. Thanks, buddy. Alright, so where did I go? Vertical? Because that's where I just came from. So it's one screen over. Oh, no, it's not. Can't do that. That's where I would come out from after I get, presumably, the Master Scroll. Oh, there's a door to the right. Hold up. And then use the angel wings to slow your descent. Proceed directly to the right. Shout out to this game for actually keeping their rooms clear after you kill them, that they don't, like, just respawn until you, like, you leave the area. Ah, here we go. Perfect, perfect. And that was, because I've already forgotten, because I have a terrible short-term memory, in case if you haven't figured that out already. Ka-ra-ura. Ka-ra-ura. And let's save. Again, it's tripping me out that I can actually see, like, the hard drive access on the Wii U. I mean, it's really cool that Wii U can actually use a hard drive. I wish it actually had it built into it. You know, like the, its contemporaries, like the Xbox 360 and the PlayStation 3. Although, I wish it took a page from the PlayStation 3 and actually made it so you could actually install your own internal hard drive instead of having to rely on external storage. Largely because the hard drive, well, I don't know what it was. Nintendo decided to not use fully powered USB ports. So you can't have the system provide power to the hard drive. It has to have its own power supply. So that's not good. So you actually have to buy a hard drive that has its own power. Which is what I have. The only problem with that is it takes up another outlet. And I have a Sega Genesis with a 32X with a Sega CD. That's three power cords. A Super Nintendo Mini. That's another power cord. An Analog NT, which is a high-definition Nintendo. That's another power cord. Nintendo 64. That's another power cord. What is next to... Oh, the Famicom Disk System. That's another power cord. My TurboGrafx Turbo Duo. That's another power cord. I have a CDX, which is not currently hooked up. That's another power cord. And then on this side of the room, I have the Xbox One power cord, Switch power cord, Wii U power cord, Xbox 360 power cord, PlayStation 3 power cord, Xbox OG Xbox power cord, GameCube power cord, Dreamcast power cord. Oh, and by the way, the Xbox One, the Wii, and the Wii U and the Xbox 360 all have external hard drives hooked up to them too. So that's an additional three power cords. Electrical outlets are at a high premium in the living room studio. If it actually had a, full powered USB ports, I could just hook in any old hard drive and let the system power that. Now, the Wii, on the other hand, actually did have bus powered USB ports, but the Wii U doesn't. And I can only presume they did that to save on cost and power consumption. Which is ridiculous, but whatever. That's why if you ever were to hook up a hard drive to the Wii U and it had its, and it was one of those bus powered ones, you had to get like one of those little Y dongles, so use draw power from the other USB port to power the hard drive. I didn't want to do that because I wanted to hook up both hard drives to the Wii U at the same time, so I could actually, that's another power supply. The hard drive that I have all my installed games on for the Wii and Wii mode, the Wii U and Wii mode. Jesus Christ, too many things. That's not good. I gotta rush him. That was bad luck. Give me some health. Damn it. Give me some health. Damn it. Oh. We have broken the 6,000 barrier. We can actually get to, okay, so we're getting really close. Like, clearly we need the Master Scroll. And the game is getting really, like, I'm sure you can hear it. The audio is getting really scratchy. And I'm gaining traction on getting health back, so I may as well save just to make sure I don't lose anything. Bum, 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 bum. If this game ever came out on Xbox One or Nintendo Switch and they fixed the handful of problems that this game has, I would gladly buy it again. Uh-oh. Is this it? No? Ooh, frame rate. Oh, that's not Elgato jitters, cats and kittens. That's frame rate. Bad frame rate. Oh my god, the slowdown is ridiculous. What the hell? Is it because there's just that much stuff going on screen? I don't remember this part running that slow. Oh god, I took damage for what? What the fucking shit? Is this room just that big that it's just sucking down all the resources? Trying so hard not to run into the spikes. Oh no. Oh, Jesus. Come on, baby. Oh, this frame rate is so brutal. I will have to give the game credit, though. The controls are not lagging. I've been in full control the entire time. Because there are some lesser games that when you have this much slowdown, you start to drop inputs. Not happening here. That's cruel. I just realized what's going to be happening down there. I'm basically just going to have to... Oh my god, I might have to duck walk the whole way. We're going to save. Thank you. Walk through the wall? Okay, it was just him walking into the foreground just a little bit. Not worth it. Not gonna bother. Christ. Need to tighten up the code. Okay. That's it? That's all that room was? Okay, well, I think that's a good place to call it for right now. That's a little silly. Whatever, man, we got through it, we got a bunch of gems, and we're still making progress towards completing this dungeon. We haven't died yet, we haven't had to go back yet, we've been doing alright, all things considered. So, we will continue to press onward, and we'll reconvene next time here, and hopefully get through this, get the Master Scroll, and go fight the boss. So, until then, thank you so much for watching, and until next time, ciao ciao.